I'm excited to demo this solo project of a parametric skateboard that I worked on over the course of 2 weeks in Rhino and Grasshopper, using some customized Python scripts using the Rhino Common API. As you can see, it loads on a rendered finished version of the model. It's all mathematically generated. And if I switch to a more technical view and turn the fillet and extrude off, and also if I turn the material to something more visible, I can show you with increased performance how everything works. So the main section is the user interface section here, and there are three other sections that generate the model: the nose, the tail here as you can see, the concave, and the holes are in the last section in the middle, and everything is brought together at the end there. There are also clearly labeled other groups that generate errors, etc. And if you zoom in here, you can see all of the smaller groups are also clearly labeled. The yellow ones are Python scripts, as you can see, using the Rhino Common API. There are some simple ones like we saw before, or this one, which is more complex. All of the yellow groups are Python, so as you can see, there are quite a few of them. If we zoom into the nose here, just to start the actual demo of the model and what it's capable of, you can see there are vectors that indicate what dimensions are actually being changed if you want. This can be handy for users. This, for example, you can see some dimensions can generate errors. So, for example, if we go below the surface of the board here, that will show that that value is incompatible. And it will also display how to fix it. So we can increase the height, and now we can see we need to increase the angle as well. And that will generate, we need to decrease that a bit. And that will generate a valid geometry, even though it is fairly extreme. Now, if we undo all of those changes and look at the top here, we can show how also the shape of the nose can be changed. So, for example, the tip squareness, the side squareness, and if I reduce the shape roundness, the overall roundness, and we can see how we can get very interesting shapes here if a user so demands. Now, if we switch the tail and turn the dimensions on, we can see all of the important lengths and angles are noted here. These update automatically. As you can see, if we increase the height to 3, we'll see it update live immediately in Rhino. And the same thing if we wanted to change the angle, say to 24, that will also display along with the geometry. So, if we turn the dimensions off again and switch the concave settings, we can see here we can change, for example, the height. I've allowed a lot of flexibility in terms of values, so even some of them might be quite extreme. I prefer giving users that freedom. We can change the flat width, the concave width, and also the slope here, which would be how steep the concave would be. So we can also change the concave settings at the nose and tail. For example, at the nose here, we can specify how long it takes to reach the maximum height and the shape of that transition. If we go and see the hole settings, we can isolate the hole dimensions on so we can display them. And we can change the hole diameter here, like so. We can change the hole's horizontal spacing and the vertical spacing between them. And we can also change the distance that they have from the nose and the tail, like so. Now, if I undo these changes and go to the render settings and turn the dimensions off, we can see we can change in technical views the color of the board, the hue of the board, the transparency of it, even the shine, the specular and diffuse settings. And if I switch to a ray trace mode, for example, here, and activate the wood material as I did before, you can see there's a more realistic mode, which was what we had at the beginning. And we can lift the board up like so and turn the extrusion and fillet back on. And that will give us a more realistic final version of the board here with a nice mirror underneath it if we so desire. So that is the complete mathematical generation of a skateboard. I hope you enjoyed, and that is that project.